Welcome to the Indy Mile for round 7 of AMA Pro Flat Track. Riders are going to have to battle an ever-changing track with long straights, tight corners, and it's going to be a night of awesome racing. Brian Smith, Mr. Mile, has won every single mile so far this season, but will he win here tonight? In 2013, Brian Smith came out on top. In 2014, Kenny Kulbeck Jr. ran away with the win. Brad Baker has been on fire but suffered a mechanical at the DuCoin Mile. Will the track tonight fit his riding style? The best in flat track starts now.
The DuCoin Magic Mile lived up to its name. GNC2 class, young riders racing like veterans on the mile. Classic mile duo comes down to Tristan Avery and the 67M of Davis Fisher, our current point leader. In the end, storybook day for Tristan Avery as he pulls off the win.
I went in turn one, about 4 laps to go, and just about kind of sending a little bit too hard, and ended up, I think almost my knee was going to the ground, and ended up saving it. Came back and catching them in about 2 laps, sent it to the checkered, and we came away with number one, so couldn't be happier.
From fighting for his life a year ago to the top of the box today, life doesn't get any sweeter for this young man. GNC1 class started off with your typical mile fashion with 6 guys going at it. Usual suspects find their way to the front, running 3, 4, sometimes 5 wide off into turn one. Five laps to go, Baker's engine expires on the factory Harley-Davidson. Down to 3, with a lap to go, it's Meads, Kulbeth, Smith, in that order. As they come off of turn 4, it looks like Meads has control. Brian Smith pulls the rabbit out of the hat, coming from 3rd to 1st, and wins in the 2nd closest Grand National finish in history, .0002.
There's very few places you go to where you can just hammer down for lap after lap after lap, and it's just fun when you can ride that hard with your buddies and clean. It's like backyard riding, but it's just so cool. So intense, it's something that you can't explain, pay for, buy, sell. It's just unbelievable, man.
Jared Vanderkoy here, 17 years old, GNC1 rookie. We're from Mount Gilead, Ohio. We're riding for the Don's Kawasaki DPC Woody Kyle Racing Kawasaki's. Definitely, it's really cool to be a part of the Saddleman Seats Rookie of the Year. Unfortunate, Kyle had to get off there and I took over the lead, but we have a pretty lengthy lead right now, about 10 points, I'm pretty sure. So, yeah, it's really cool with Saddleman putting up the money and going for this award. The ultimate goal is to get the championship, but this year is the Rookie of the Year. We're going to finish up there, and hopefully we'll break the top 10 by the end of the year. We're sitting 17th in points right now. Struggled a little bit here and there, but definitely championship. That's what we're going for.
Hi, I'm Ricky Howerton. I am part owners in the Crosley Howerton Esparza 42 team. We've been around since 2012. The team consists of Bo Lamastis at Crosley, Joe Esparza, myself, Jeff Gordon, Ron Glidden, and Ryan Smith as a rider. Being that this is our fifth year in the race series, we've put a tremendous amount of effort in this team to try to get it to the point that it is now. We basically all have day jobs. We do this at night, so we're working 12, 15, 18-hour days. It's been a big strain, I think, on everyone personally, but it's definitely been probably, and I can speak for everyone on the team, probably some of the funnest years that we've ever had. Overall, our decision with Kawasaki has been a great one, as it's shown great reliability. And with Kawasaki stepping in the sanction this year, it's been a great decision.
You know, Ricky's the driving force behind me riding and the rest of the team doing the hard work, really. I mean, he's the guy that keeps the wheels turning, whether we like it or not. Whether it's me winning and he's picking apart my riding to go faster the next week, which I like, or leaning on the crew to get the work done and make sure we got the best equipment at the track, and it shows. I mean, sometimes I think we all joke that he's a slave driver, but it's helped the results, and that's the way it should be for sure.
We're committed to get Brian that number one plate, and whatever it takes effort-wise and resources is what we're gonna do.
Jared Mees, Grand National number one.
Brian Smith, National number 42.
Hey, I'm Sammy Halbert, number 7. Watch me live on FanChoice.tv.
I'm Kenny Coolbeth, watching live on FansChoice.tv.
Hey, I'm Brandon Robinson, match number 44. I'm watching you live on FansChoice.tv.
I'm Shayna Texter, number 52, and you're watching me live on FansChoice.tv.
Miles, number 17, watch me live on FansChoice.tv.
Check, 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 check.
I'm Rob Pearson, number 27, KTM, GE, Waters Auto.
Bye.
I'm Jeffrey Carver, national number 23, watch me on FansChoice.tv.
Johnny Lewis, watch me live on FansChoice.tv.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Who's ready for the legendary Indy Mile? Make some noise. All right, you're going to have to get louder and crazier than that. We're going to switch it up a little bit. We're going to run an abbreviated program. We have seen that there is weather coming. We're going to do everything we can to get as much racing in as we can. So what that means is there's going to be 3 GNC1 heat races. That's how we'll start the show. We'll take the top 6 finishers directly to the main event. Then we'll go to the GNC2 heat races. There's 2 heat races. We'll take the top 9 riders to their main event. We'll take a short break, come right back with the GNC1 main event, and that will be 25 laps, and then we'll come with the GNC2 main event, which is scheduled, I believe, for 12 laps. Don't quote me on that one. And then after that, we will have our important Dash for Cash. So we want you guys to see as much racing as possible here at the Indy Mile. So we've abbreviated the program. We're still running the important races, the qualifying race and the main event, and then hopefully we can get that Dash for Cash in at the end of tonight's program. So That being said, that takes care of all of our housekeeping notes. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce our trophy girls. Please welcome Jillian, Sylvia, and Katie up here to the victory podium. Here they are from Harley-Davidson and from Vance and Hines. They'll stand up here on the victory podium. We got two of them up here already. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce my co-host for this year, his first year with us. He's a seven-time champion, a four-time winner of the Indy Mile. Make some noise for the seven-time champ, Chris Carr. Chris, welcome up here to the podium. It's got to feel good to be back here at the Indy Mile.
It does feel good. You know, this race has a lot of great memories for me as a competitor, and I'm looking forward to living some memories tonight, watching these guys go out there and give it their all.
Well, I saw your parents are actually up there in the stands, and do they know that you're not racing anymore?
Yeah, they are well aware of that, and I think they're happy for that.
So they are just hardcore flat track fans. They're at every race I go to, no matter where we go. But what's it going to take to win here at the Indy Mile?
Well, I think tonight the track conditions are going to change quite a bit. The rider that adapts his style and the team that kind of helps adapt their motorcycle to change ever-changing conditions is going to be the guy that gets to the checker flag first. It's going to be a little compromise on all their parts to get to the front.
All right, we got an abbreviated program there telling me to fly through opening ceremonies. You've got to go over there to our booth. I'll see you over there in just about 20 minutes.
All right, sounds good. Thanks for coming out, folks.
That is the seven-time champion, Chris Carr, ladies and gentlemen. Up next, I'd like to bring out our Motobat Hard Charger from last week at DuCoin, and he is also our Dunlop social media winner, and he is riding the Ducati. He said he makes his home now in Florida. Make some noise for national number 10, Johnny Lewis. Oh, he's bringing his own trophy girl with him. That is Miss Vance and Hines coming out. Johnny, you got $250 from Motobat for being the hard charger from last week. Congratulations. I know that's not the check you wanted, but you finished fourth. That's how you earned that check from coming deep in the field, working your way to the front.
Yeah, it was a fun race. We started third row, and, you know, unfortunately there was a red flag, but it was good for me, and I was able to get the bike up a little farther and just get a nice, smooth race.
You've had that Ducati Scrambler running really good this season. What's it going to take to put it on top of the box for the first time?
You know, just more time. You know, I'm figuring out the track. I felt really good last practice. You know, just good track conditions and have some fun. And then when I'm smiling, I usually go fast. So
the track looks like it's changing. They did add some moisture. Will that help the Ducati hook up, or you're going to ride the Highlander? What you going to do?
We'll see when we get out there how the track conditions are. I think I'm third heat, so I always like when there's moisture, so I go fast when it's hooked up.
You also put a cool social media post about Dunlop tires, and you just won yourself a new set of tires. That's going to help, too.
Yeah, you know, it's we burned off some rubber out here, but, you know, thanks for Dunlop for putting that up. And it's always fun to kind of come up with different hashtags and share stuff like that on the social media. And it's always fun to get some extra prizes.
Yeah, $250, new set of tires. It's starting out to be a good day so far. Maybe we'll see you on top of the box at the end of the night.
Yeah, that's the plan, Scotty.
You want to thank anybody before we let you go?
Yeah, just a lot of Ducati fans came out today. It's really neat. Got a big group picture. Just thanks for all those guys coming out. And, you know, everybody supports the team.
All right, so I got Johnny Lewis now out of Florida. Is that right? Am I hearing rumors or what?
No, I'm down there now. It's my home base. I'm going to go down for the wintertime and train and ride and have some fun.
All right, Johnny, best luck today.
Thank you.
That's Johnny Lewis, ladies and gentlemen, riding the Lloyd Brothers Motorsports Ducati Scrambler, number 10. Keep your eyes on him all night. Up next, I'd like to bring out our Saddleman Seats and Saddlebags Rookie of the Year leader. He's got number 17F this year. Next year, he will have a national number. Make some noise for Jared Vanderkoy. Jared, welcome up here to the victory podium. Now you know where it's at. You actually won here last year in the GNC2 class. What's it going to take to pull out a victory here today?
It's going to take off a good heat race. You know, we got to get off the line, get up top two for the main event. So we'll get front row for the main, and we'll see how it goes. You know, run consistent laps and pick out some good lines. So we'll see how it goes.
We do have an abbreviated program, no semis. Does that put pressure on you for your heat race?
Definitely. You know, you just got to ride like any other heat. You know, you go out there to win. So we're confident with our changes we made. So I'm proud.
What would it mean to you to take home the Rookie of the Year and $5,000 from Saddleman Seats and Saddlebags if you keep it up?
That would definitely be a moment, a bit older for us. And thanks for Saddleman putting up the money. You know, I know a lot of you have Saddleman Seats and Saddlebags on your Harleys out there. And I just appreciate the award, and it would go far in my career.
Right, you want to say thanks to anybody else before we let you go?
Yeah, I'd like to thank the whole Don's Kawasaki, DPC Racing, Floyd Tab, Bordicaw Racing, Ben Evans, Spectra Oils, Ben Evans, Motorcycle Superstore, Bell Helmets, all your fans for coming out that it did. Hopefully we get a bigger turnout next year, but thanks for coming out.
There you go. Best of luck to you tonight.
Thank you.
That is our Saddleman Rookie of the Year leader, number 17F, Jared Vandekoy. Up next, we're going to bring out our GNC 2 points leader. If he wins the championship, he will take home a TDFJ custom designed ring. Make some noise for our points leader. Number 67M is Dashin' Davis Fisher. Davis, you got this nice ring out here. You're in control of the points lead right now here in GNC 2 class. What would it mean to win the championship and take home that Tommy Dumas Fine Jewelers race ring?
It would mean pretty cool. Coming up 1 point short last year, it'd be cool to be wearing the ring next year and in the expert class.
You set a pretty fast time out there earlier. So far, the day's starting out pretty good. What's it going to take for a victory here in the GNC2 class?
I mean, get a good heat race and hopefully win it and hopefully move on to the heat main and get a good start and just put my head down and go.
How does this track compare to last week's DuCoin Mile?
Not very the same, but I mean, it's loose like it was in practice. Hopefully it grooves up and we can ring around the bottom.
Sounds good. You want to thank any of your sponsors before we let you go?
Yeah, I think Parkson Brothers Racing, Ball Blanfiers, Beaverton Honda, Rye Helmets, Danwall Racing, Race Tech, Allied Motors, Saddleman Seats, Fly Racing, Team 95, and all you fans for coming out and the AMA for putting the show on.
All right. Best of luck to you tonight.
Thank you.
Keep your eyes on our points, GNC2 class number 67M, Dashin' Davis Fisher. Up next, I'll bring up our GNC1 points leader. He's also our defending Grand National Champion. If he wins the championship, he'll take home his second Rolex in 2 years. Make some noise for the jammer, Jared Meese. He's over there sleeping on the stage. He's up in the first heat race trying to get some strategy. Were you taking a cat nap over there, or what were you doing?
I thought I was going last.
You are last. It's time to go. All these people are here to see you.
Oh, cool.
You like that?
I love it.
How's your Harley-Davidson running today?
Harley-Davidson's running awesome. I got Kenny Tolbert behind the wrenches and Sammy Sweet, so no reason why it shouldn't.
Well, you're holding on to hopefully a life-size Rolex, but what would it mean to you to win the championship again and take home your second Rolex in 2 years?
It'd be awesome. You know, them things are really easy on the eyes. You know, they're nice, and if I get more than one, then I can start collecting them.
Start a collection. You might as well start with this year. You're looking good so far. You're still looking for your first win of the season. What would it mean to get your first win right here tonight at the Indy Mile?
Indy's a pretty cool place, especially being in Michigan. A lot of family and friends come down to watch. Indy's been somewhere place that I've, you know, grew up racing since I've been an amateur, so really looking forward to it.
Well, sounds good. I know we're trying to get you out there. You're in the first heat race, so you want to thank your sponsors before we let you go to work?
Yeah, big shout out to just the whole Rogers race in Las Vegas, Harley-Davidson, SDI Insulation, Family Events are putting on an awesome event here last weekend and this weekend. National Cycle, Bullet Jeans, Monster Energy Drink, just like I said, all my supporters, Tommy Dumas for the awesome Rolex watch, and like I said, all you supporters out there and the fans.
All right, best of luck to you today. You're in the first heat race. Go get them.
Thanks a lot.
That is the jammer, ladies and gentlemen. Number one on an armor plate, that is Jared Meese. Well, that is all the riders I've lined up. I've got a couple of sponsors, and then I've got to bring up our Grand Marshal up first for our sponsors. This is the Harley-Davidson GNC1 class presented by Vance and Hines. So at this time, I'd like to have Terry Vance from Vance and Hines and Chris Schoonover from Harley-Davidson Motor Company to come on up here if we can. And Chris Schoonover and his beard are here. He brought his bodyguard. Chris, you have your bodyguards up here. How are you feeling tonight?
Feeling great. We had a great race last week in DuCoin, and this weather's perfect right now. Let's get it on.
All right, who are your bodyguards before we get to racing action?
This is my youngest son, Clayton, my oldest son, Kane.
They haven't started growing their beards yet?
Yeah, they're trying. It's just peach fuzz at this point.
All right, that's Chris Schoonover, Harley-Davidson Motor Company. Come on over here. This is Terry Vance, ladies and gentlemen, Vance and Hines. Terry, welcome to the Indy Mile. Are you ready for tonight's racing action?
Yeah, I am, Scott. You know, the last couple races have just been so exciting. That last race finished at 0-0 between the two guys. Was unbelievable. I would have liked to seen Brad be in that mix, but had a little problem. But he's been running really good. I'm really excited today. I think he's going to do really well here.
So that's who you're picking is Brad Baker, the factory Harley with the Vance and Hines backing?
Yeah, absolutely. We're just privileged to be involved with the guys with Schoonover and Baker and all the team. It's just great. But flat track in general, Scotty, it's just been doing so good this year. I'm really excited to be a part of it.
Well, Terry Vance, thanks for being a part of opening ceremonies. Have a great night here at the Indy Mile.
Hey, thanks, Scotty. And you and Chris are doing a great job on Fans Choice.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Schoonover from Harley-Davidson Motor Company and Terry Vance from Vance and Hines. And now, you Indiana fans, you know this guy. He's our Grand Marshal. He was actually racing out here last year. I know him as number 31. Make some noise for Dan the Man, Dan Ingram. Dan, welcome back out here to the Indy Mile. I know you want to be out there racing, but you've elected to hang it up again. You made a comeback for about 3 years. It was awesome watching the progress. You ran so strong, and you decided to hang it up again, but we appreciate you being the Grand Marshal here tonight.
Well, thank you very much, Scott. You know, promotions, family events, and the AMA. I've been hearing a lot of advertisement on the radios and TVs, and that's very commendable. And I'm glad to really see that, and makes me really excited to be out here.
How hard is it to sit back and watch? I know it's driving me crazy. I'm in the truck over there. Chris Carr sits back over there, and we want to be out there every week. But how hard is it going to be for you to watch the Indy Mile tonight?
I'll tell you, I've ridden here the last 3 years after an 18-year layoff. And I've been loving it, and it's going to be hard to not be on the bike tonight.
What are you going to pick a winner, or who do you think is going to be going fast tonight?
Well, watching practice speeds, man, there's a handful of guys, I mean, that are right there, and it's going to be hard to say.
How about these great fans? Every time we announce your name the last couple of years, you know, they put their hands together. They love you, Dan. I mean, it's really cool that you can be part of opening ceremonies and be tonight's Grand Marshal.
Well, thank you very much, man. I'm right here in Indianapolis, and I appreciate the support of everybody. And, you know, when I started my comeback, I had Tom Cummings helping me, and Indy Southside Harley-Davidson, Harley-Davidson of Bloomington, Indiana. You know, and then Three Bears Racing, Joe Davis stepped on board and was helping me out last year. And I've had a lot of good support from a lot of people, and I'm very thankful.
Well, we appreciate it. Loved watching you all throughout the years of your entire career. Have a good time tonight, and congratulations on being the Grand Marshal. That's really cool.
All right. Thanks very much, man. Thank you all for coming out.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for our Grand Marshal, Dan Ingram, former national number 31. Well, they're saying it's time to go racing, so I'm going to hand things over to the third member of our team. You met Chris Carr earlier, now here to be doing the winning interviews. She comes to us from Minnesota via San Diego. Her name is Danny Medine, and she's going to take care of the rest of opening ceremonies. I've got to go all the way to the announcer's booth. Danny, have a good time at the Indy Mile. You got some motor maids lined up. You got all kinds of cool stuff, and then we're going racing real quick and fast. Have fun.
All right. You have fun.
I will.
I have the best seat in the house. Thank you all for joining us this evening. Will you please rise and remove your hats? Raymond Rizzo from Motor Racing Outreach is going to lead us in the invocation.
Thank you, Danny. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for this beautiful day and opportunity to do what we love. Thank you for all your grace and mercy, seen and unseen. Praying for every rider. Help them to do their best today. I ask also for their crews, their sponsors, their families. Bless each and every one. Thank you for all those that worked so hard to put this event on, all the AMA Pro Flat Track, and all the people here today. Bless each and every one. Thank you for all those that are watching by Fans Choice. I pray your blessings upon them. Heal all our friends that need it. And I also ask for our military around the world, oh God. Keep your hands of love and protection around them. Thank you for everyone. In Jesus' name, amen.
And now make some noise for the Motor Maids, who are the oldest North American Women's Motorcycle Club. They're going to present our colors. And now from Nashville, Tennessee, please welcome Bo Braswell of EMI and Twist Grip Recordings.
Oh, say, Can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Now, are you guys ready for the best in flat track? Make some noise.
Thanks a lot, Danny. It's time for the Indy Mile. I'm Scotty Dibbler. I'm in the booth with the seven-time champ, Chris Carr. Chris, we're up here in the booth now. It is go time. We're switching the program over to GNC1s. Will be coming up first. Three heat races. We'll take the top six out of the heat races directly to the main event. How does that change the way you go into the heat race?
Well, I mean, everybody, this is their one shot to get to the finals. So they can't save it. They got to run up toward the front. Those that want to get in the dash need to get in the top two. Those that want to make it the main event got to get in the top six. So there's no second chances tonight. I know we have a little bit of a weather issue possibly here in the near future, so we're going to do everything we can to get this event in.
How would this affect you as a motorcycle racer? Say you went out there and didn't qualify very good. You're starting near the back of the pack. What would change to going out to this race?
Well, as a rider, you go out there and you do the best that you can. You know, you go out there, this is what you have. I think there's more pressure on the mechanics and teams. You know,
oh, wow.
Those guys, you know, they know their stuff's got to be right when it goes out on the racetrack, because there's no second chance for them either. There's no pulling out a spare for a semi or anything like that. So pressure's on everybody to perform.
For you folks just joining us, we're going to have three GNC1 heat races coming up first. We'll take the top six finishers directly to the main event. After that, we'll go into GNC2, just like I talked about just a few moments ago in opening ceremonies. We'll take the top nine finishers out of the GNC2 heat race finishers, and then we'll have our first GNC1 main event. Do you like the call that they're making here?
Well, whenever you have impending weather, I think it's a good thing. These guys came here to race. They don't get the race, they don't get paid. So I think everybody wants to see a show. Giving up the semis and the LCQ three events, I think is a good call overall for the series, for the riders, the teams. You know, they've got 3 weeks off before they got to be in Rapid City. So, I think it's a good call to accelerate the program and get it going.
And the fans in the stands, hopefully we'll get to see all the races. We're going to have three GNC1 heat races coming up first. As soon as that track's ready, the riders are strapping on their helmets, making sure their steel shoes are tight. And they're going to come out, and they're going to get one lap to check out the racetrack, because we did some track maintenance between qualifying practice and what happened, you know, what's going on right now. So they're going to send them out according to how they lined up for heat race number one. What do you do when you're out there in the siding lap?
Well, you know, you see how they've changed the track. You know, they've watered it. They've drug it a little bit. Maybe they've bladed it in a few spots. And basically, it gives you a chance, maybe not at 10 tenths to go around the racetrack, but to get an idea where there might be some slippery spots, where the track feels good, possibly in the cushion. And I'm sure number six is going to go make sure that cushion hasn't been padded down too tight, because he's going to go to the hay bales.
He will go to the high side. So here's your starting lineup for heat race number one on the pole. Number six from Eatonville, Washington, the factory Harley. That's the Bullet, Brad Baker. Starting second from Clio, Michigan, is the Jammer, the defending champion, Jared Meese. Starting third on the front row from Crystal, Michigan, that is Henry Wiles, who was running up front last week until he went down near the end of that main event. Starting fourth from Oxford, Pennsylvania, is the 44, Brandon Robinson. Starting fifth from Ocampo, California, on the Weirbach Kawasaki, that's 91, of Mikey Martin. Starting sixth, the last rider on the front row on the KTM GE Capital Waters auto body team, number 27, Robbie Pearson, will be starting in the sixth spot. Row number two, 96, Cody Johncox. 82, Jeremy Higgins. We have the 16, Wyatt McGuire. 61, Dustin Crow. 89, Evan Baer. 90, W on a borrowed motorcycle here this weekend. That is Wyatt Anderson. And the 13X starting back on row number three by himself is Ken Maynard. That is your starting lineup for heat race number one. GNC1s to the track first, and they are getting staged up over there in the staging area. Heat race number one is scheduled to be 8 laps the distance in the GNC1 class, 6 laps for the GNC2s, and again, we'll take the top 6 finishers out of this one. Again, the top 2 will go to the Dash for Cash, and that Dash for Cash will be the last race of the night, depending on what goes on with the weather. Also, just a reminder, the Class of 79 and friends are down there selling 50-50 tickets. Stop by and get them. They're already over $520, so that means over 260 to the winner. So well, they're walking around the grandstands. Get your tickets while you can. That money goes to help riders to get hurt in our sport, the greatest sport in the world, Grand National Flat Track Racing. And we're getting set to go with heat race number one. Like I said, they're going to get a siding lap, and then they'll stage them up to the line, and we will go racing. We're starting about 5 minutes early, and we'll keep the show going as fast as we can so we can get as many races in. Hopefully we get all the races in before Mother Nature decides to do something different.
Well, I saw a lot of people in the pit area earlier looking at their phones and looking at the weather reports, and there's a big blob of stuff
coming.
It's on its way. It was at the Illinois-Indiana border the last I saw. So hopefully we can get this thing going. Fans can get their money's worth. Riders can get their points in their purse. And everybody goes home as happy as possible.
And they said the track is clear. They're going to send them out again for one siding lap. It's going to be the Bullet, Brad Baker. Jared Meese on the one. 17 is Henry Wiles. 44, Brandon Robinson. 91, Mikey Martin. And 27, Robbie Pearson will be the first 6 riders out, and that will be your front row. Qualifying practice was earlier this afternoon, and they are coming to the track right now again to get one lap to check out the racetrack. The Bullet will lead them out.
Yeah, these guys will want to get up to speed as we see Brad.
Straight to the top.
Looks like they might have groomed it a little bit at the top. The bottom has been kind of rolled in, so the guys are going to have kind of an option. You can try and run low on a hard-packed track, or you can run it to the top and run the cushion. And I know the 17 of Henry Wiles, he loves it up in the cushion. The Harleys, though, tend to work the best down on the little blue groove on the bottom, as we see Meese kind of testing the middle of the racetrack. It's going to be interesting to see how this track develops over the course of the heat races and see how much it changes. And yes, I know you're staring at what bike Jared Meese is on, and they told me he was definitely running the reverse cylinder head on the rear. So you'll see, if you look down there by his left knee, there above his foot dragging on the ground, you'll see a carburetor and air filter sticking out the front, and that's because they've turned the head around backwards.
So they have one air filter and one out of each side, actually, in one cylinder, at the rear cylinder is completely turned around the other way. So that's why I was checking out on the number one bike. Seems to be working. He likes running that bike on the mile. So they'll pull up to the starting line. This is the Harley-Davidson GNC1 class presented by Vance and Hines. Heat race number one pulls to the line right now. It looks like they have an orange stripe across the front straightaway. It's kind of hard to see from our vantage point here in the booth, but there you can see the finish line is definitely painted. The white checkered board stripe right there is the starting line, so they are using orange paint instead of the typical white, so it's kind of hard to see the line. There are laser beams that go across every row. Track is clear. Ladies and gentlemen, it's heat race time at the Indy Mile. This is the GNC1 class. Scheduled for 8 laps, 8 miles, and we'll pick the top 6 finishers directly to tonight's main event. Top 2 finishers go to the Dash for Cash. Chris?
10-second board is off. Red light goes on, then we'll see a first yellow. We'll go to a second yellow, and there's the green. Off we go. Good start by the number one up front, headed up to the front.
27
up the inside on the KTM there.
Robbie Pearson snags the whole shot from the inside. He'll lead him into turn number one, but looks like Jared Meese is going to lead him off of turn number two. A little bit of dust flying already. Now Meese is your leader. Bugs Pearson sits in second. Baker in the third spot. Down the back straightaway they go. Lap number one. We are racing at Indianapolis.
We saw the number six of Baker get a little bit coated right there. He's going to have to go extra wide to go up around the outside of the roost of the number one. We'll see if he can make some time like he did earlier in practice. No advantage that time, but he's lined up for a draft down the front stretch.
Meese leads him off of four. Here comes Brad Baker. We got Pearson and Robinson third and fourth side by side down the front straightaway. Into turn number one we go. Baker takes the lead into one.
And we see a little difference there. Meese kind of blows through the roost real quick. Doesn't get sprayed down quite as much, but man, that was a great turn one and two for Baker. Opens up about
it. Meese is having problems.
Meese is out. Something happening to his Harley-Davidson. That's a big blow to our championship leader here. Something wrong with the number one motorcycle there. Looks like it's expired. Point leader taking it on the chin tonight.
Meese out of the race. Looks good thing that he has a provisional leftover. He'll possibly have to use that because there's no semifinals. So the points leader sitting and watching on the back straightaway. Second now is Robinson. Third is Wiles. Robbie Pearson still in the four spot. Fifth is Wiles. They went across last time. Mikey Martin's right there in the sixth spot. Remember, top six finishers go to the main. And now here comes Wyatt McGuire up to the sixth position down the back straightaway. Brad Baker's got plenty of breathing room before everybody else comes across.
Well, he's picking up where he left off. His lap time's not quite as fast as they were in qualifying. He's running around at a 30, well, maybe a little bit quicker. Yeah, here at 37.6. Good lap times. We're starting to see a little bit rubber develop, but right now, Brad Baker doesn't want to see any blue groove. He wants to see this thing loose all the way around the Indy Mile.
Absolutely. So Baker pulling away. Brandon Robinson still in second. Third is Henry Wiles. Fourth is Pearson on the 27. He's trying to punch his ticket to the main event because he knows if you don't do it here, you are done for the night. Down the back straightaway they go. Baker with about a 3-second lead now. Robinson in second. Third is Wiles. Those two are sitting there, second and third. Pearson fourth, Mikey Martin. Cody Johncox now has got the 96 machine up there.
Yeah, the sixth and final transfer position in the hands of Cody Johncox at the moment. You know, top six straight to the main, no second chances. And as Baker continues to gap the field, a good run by Robinson here. He didn't have a very strong DuCoin. Didn't look to be overly comfortable earlier today, but he's up there near the hay bales.
And he's holding off Wiles, who's normally a hard charger on the loose track, so he goes really good. So Wiles tucks in behind the Triumph down the back straightaway. Now Mikey Martin still in the fourth spot, and in fifth is Robbie Pearson. And sixth now, Johncox has a little bit of breathing room. Top six to the main event. We're just past the halfway point. Or just coming to the halfway point, I believe.
Well, I notice here the track appears to be a little bit on the dry side. I'm sure they're a little bit gun-shy on the amount of water. And be interesting to see how long the cushion can last. You know, it's one thing when it's there, but when it's not wet and usable, that can narrow the racetrack up. As we see the 91 of Mikey Martin sliding in a little low, skates up through the middle. I don't see a whole lot of rubber develop in turns one and two, but we might see a stripe around the bottom in three and four by the end of the night.
Looks like one and two, a lot of the riders are choosing the higher line, three and four. Some of the riders are ducking down to the bottom line, and a little bit of rubber is going down. Again, we're cutting a few races out, two semis and one last chance qualifier, basically. So only three races we're cutting out. So the track should develop like it would at the end of the night, but not a lot of moisture on the racetrack because in case Mother Nature comes, we want to be prepared for it.
Yeah, keeping it a little bit on the dry side is as we have two laps to go here for our leader, Brad Baker. We're about a lap and a half as far ahead as he is with everybody else right now. But this track is going to go through some changes, and they're happening before our eyes right now.
There's a look at Baker. He's still running the high line up above the deepest part of the cushion all by himself, and then he'll drop down to the bottom coming off of the corner. Baker out front. The factory Harley is hooked up and flying here tonight, so it's Baker at the point. Brandon Robinson in second, Wiles in third.
Yeah, just saw him go through turns three and four as we have the white flag coming out as Brad Baker leads him into the last lap. Getting the thing up there high, getting it turned, getting good drives off the corner is Wiles now trying to make a move on the 44. Through the up the inside, comes in a little higher, trying to come off a little lower, see if he can get the drive.
Robinson knows he's there now. He just looked over his shoulder. Here they come down the back straight. Best race for second and third.
Interesting here, the Triumph, very strong. He comes off in a position to draft and actually puts a little bit of distance on him. So good straight line speed by the latest Motorsports Triumph.
And that is who goes to the dash for cash also. So whoever finishes in the two spot goes to the dash. Brad Baker takes home the win here in heat race number one on the factory Harley. Baker, your winner. Here comes the race for second across the line. And it's going to be the 44. Looks like he had the drive off of four. So Robinson goes to the dash for cash. Here comes the rest of the riders across the finish line. Second is Robinson. Third is Wiles. Remember, the top six finishers all going to the main event. Baker put it on him in this one. See if that track will hold up. His fastest lap was a 3.7634. So Brad Baker takes the win. Second spot will be the 44, the tall drink of water from Pennsylvania. That's Brandon Robinson. Those two go to the dash. Third is Henry Wiles. Fourth is Robbie Pearson. Fifth is 91, Mikey Martin. And your final qualifier is the 96 of Cody Johncox. A tough break for the defending champion, number one, Jared Meese. He will have a provisional start card because he finished in the top 10 in the points. There's a look at our results from heat race number one. Behind sixth was Wyatt McGuire, seventh, Jeremy Higgins, Dustin Crow, Evan Baer, Wyatt Anderson, and Ken Maynard. And then Jared Meese finishes in the 13th spot. He broke early on. There's the bullet. He's super pumped to be winning heat race number one. He's going to head up to that victory podium if he can figure out his way to get up there and talk to Danny Medine up there on that victory podium. He's looking for a way through. Got to go past the stage, through the mud.
This guy's been hotter than a firecracker the last few weeks. You know, he had a great great outing at Lima, sweeping everything, every round. He was the fast guy. He was doing the same thing at DeCoin, was in the hunt for a real close finish there with Coolbeth and Meese before his bike expired. Let's see if he can continue it on tonight. He's certainly off to a great start.
We'll give him just a second to take off his beautiful helmet. It's got Monster Energy on board. The factory Harley leathers looking good on the victory podium. As soon as that helmet comes off, we're going to go trackside with Danny Medine and our heat race winner. Danny, take it away.
You guys, make some noise for Brad Baker. You have had a target on your back since Lima, since DuCoin. You gotta be feeling pretty good right now, Brad. What is so great about the Indy Mile?
I love the Indy Mile. You know, I've always had a lot of fun here. It just, all the pieces haven't exactly been put together in the past, and now I think everything's finally coming in alignment with the Harley-Davidson Motor Company putting in so much effort into this program, along with Vance and Hines coming on board, along with Showa Racing Suspension. They're by far the best motorcycles I've ever ridden, and I got to give a big thanks to Harley-Davidson for making that happen. So I'm just having fun, you know. The motorcycles are gelling with me, and I'm gelling with them. The team's working hard, and you know, this racetrack's a little bit more my style, being a little bit wetter and cushed up, and I think it might stay that way for a lot of the evening, so that will definitely be good in our suit. So just having fun and going as fast as I can.
All right, congratulations, Scotty and Chris, back to you guys.
All right, congratulations goes out to the bullet, Brad Baker. Here comes heat race number two on the pole from Flint, Michigan. It's number 42. He's won 3 miles. He's got 3 wins this season. 42 is Brian Smith. From Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania, on the KTM, number 32, Sean Baer. From Salinas, California, on the number 80, that's Stevie Bonzi. From Graham, Washington, number 7, Slammin' Sammy Halbert. From Clio, Michigan, the racing lady, number 15, Nicole Meese. Last rider on the front row is our rookie of the year leader, number 17F, Jared Vandekoy. Row number 2, 87, Mick Kirkness, 49, Chad Coase, 67, Colt Chabot, 29, Jake Mataya, 72, Chaz Landers, 52 is Shayna Texter. So we got two females in this one. And then on row number 3, by himself, is national number 21 from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. That's Duke Erickson. This is heat race number 2, GNC1 class, top 6 finishers to the main event. Track's clear. Here we go, Chris.
Yeah, I just noticed the number 80, Steve Bonzi, riding the XTCR motorcycle. Actually, I believe it still belongs to them.
Nick Cummings,
yep. And his father Tommy from TCR Racing are in the house tonight. So it's good to see the number 80 on a bike that I actually rode at Calistoga one of my years racing. So this is a good motorcycle for him.
Clutches come out. 32 gets a terrible start. He's going backwards. It's Bonzi grabbing the hole shot. Nicole Meese on the inside. So we got 80 and the 15. Now here comes the 7 of Sammy Halbert coming up there. And Sean Baer goes to the high side. So he's got his KTM working now. He got a terrible start, but he's charging around. He's going to try to lead him off of turn number 2.
Yeah, good drive up around the outside. Gets into a drag race. And we saw his bike have a little shimmy earlier
wow.
in the day. Still doing that, but it's not slowing him down as he flicks it off into turn 3. Bonzi goes way up to the top, trying to avoid the roost, cuts down underneath. We'll see if he can get a drive and get a good toe down the front as Smith comes up to the third position.
Sean Baer will lead him off of turn number 4. Bonzi in second, Brian Smith third, Sammy Halbert, Nicole Meese fourth and fifth. Here they come, Vandekoy in the 6th spot. Top 6 finishers all go to the main event. Sean Baer goes to the bottom of the racetrack on the KTM. I'm surprised to see that.
Well, sometimes, you know, it's a kind of a comfort level. Turn 1's a little bit different. You just kind of go in there as deep as you can and let the thing float up as Smith gets a good run through 1 and 2.
Bonzi
goes around. Bonzi has an issue waving his arms to those behind him. Something wrong with his XRC. 750 as well.
That's a tough break for him because he has no second chance to get in the main event. He has no provisional. And so Bonzi is off the pace. So we'll go back out front. It's Sean Bear on the 32. Brian Smith on the 42. Down the front straightaway they go. Look at the 32 pulling away from the 42 going into one.
That is a rare sight right there to see any motorcycle out accelerate the 42. As Smith now riding up on the low side of the cushion. Bear gets up into the deep stuff, slows it down a little bit. Let's see if the 32 can pull out and go on by. This is a rare sight as well.
Coming back, no problem. The Harleys haven't been able to do that just yet, but the KTM of Sean Bear able to make that happen, but now he has to tuck back in. So now it's going to be experience on this track, and Brian Smith will lead him off of four. Sean Bear sitting in second. Nicole Meese is up to the third spot. Sammy Halbert back to fourth. Jared Vandekoy, and now Mick Kirkness from Australia is up to the sixth spot.
Well, you know, one of the things about dirt track racing, it's always good to have a lot of horsepower, but the other thing is you got to get through the corners. And the one thing that Brian Smith has done here year after year after year is find his way to get through those corners as faster than anybody.
How cool was it to have Ricky Howerton up here explaining the story of how things got going? And he grew up, you know, watching Bubba Schobert, Ricky Graham, and the factory Honda teams right here in Indianapolis, and now he's out here, his bike's leading this heat race.
Yeah, it's got to be a great feeling to see all of his hard work from everybody at Howerton Motorsports lead at a race here in his hometown. Nod there to Sean Bear, though, keeping him in check as close as possible as we've got a battle here for the fourth position between Halbert and Vandekoy heating up.
The rookie goes on by Sammy Halbert, but he slips a little bit wide in turn number one. Sammy's on the Kawasaki, still trying to adjust. He rode Harleys in his entire career until this year, and he's got the Briggs Auto Kawasaki. Now he's just dropped back one more spot, so he's back in the fifth spot as Vandekoy moves up to fourth.
Well, you know, interesting for Sammy. He, you know, riding the Harleys, we see him running the low line through turn three. The track right now is like what I call a tweener racetrack. It's between being a cushion and it's between being a groove. It hasn't made up its mind what it wants to do yet. But as we start to see some of these riders start going down to the bottom, we're going to start seeing a little bit of rubber lay in, and it could change the whole outcome of the race.
Here comes the California kid, Chad Coase. He's got to pick up one more spot if he wants to go to the main event. We'll see what happens as we go back to Vandekoy and Sammy Halbert. They're battling back here for fourth and fifth. It is Brian Smith who's checked out. Sean Bear in second. Nicole Meese by herself in third. Fourth and fifth is Vandekoy and Sammy. And now Chad Coase has put the 49 up to the sixth spot. Remember, six riders to the main. Everybody else is done until we go to Rapid City 3 weeks from now.
Well, you know, this is an important battle for this fourth position because it, you know, fourth puts you on the second row. Fifth puts you on the third row.
Oh.
And on a track like this where visibility is a difficulty, as the 87 comes back by the 49 there for our last transfer spot. Mick Kirkness from Australia.
Whoa,
they both go deep up in the cushion in turns three and four, fighting for that last transfer position.
Kirkness has his hands full on the KTM. Chad Coase on the Kawasaki goes up the inside. Looks like a little bit smoother line. They'll go down the back straightaway. Kirkness pulls out, tries to draft on by, and does. What a battle for that sixth and final transfer spot. White flag should be coming out here real soon for Brian Smith on the 42 Crosley Brands Kawasaki. There it is.
Great run for Smith up front as he has opened up a 2.5 second gap over that of Sean Bear. Sean Bear equally two seconds is a great battle here as the white flag is out. This is the final position going into the final here. No semis. No last chance. Their last chance is this last lap of this heat race.
Brian Smith, now he drives the bottom of the racetrack. It's a good, smart rider right there. He's been running the high line. Now he drops to the bottom, wants to see what it's like as the rubber is being laid down on the inside. Here comes your heat race winner, heat race number two of the Harley-Davidson GNC1 class presented by Vance and Hines. It'll be Brian Smith taking a win, going home. Second spot is going to be the 32 of Sean Bear, just now crosses the finish line. There's Nicole Meese, puts herself in the main. Vandekoy will come home in the fourth spot. Sammy Halbert in fifth, and here comes the drag race for that final transfer, and it's going to be Chad Coase, the California kid, going to the main event. Any surprises in that one, Chris?
No, not really. Chad Coase, good run, coming from the second row starting position, gets himself into the main event. I'm a little surprised by the struggle of the number seven of Sammy Halbert, of fifth place. It's kind of out of character for him this year. He's been in the top five on several of the miles, and to see him having to start from row three, he's got a lot of work cut out to maintain his spot in the points.
There's your rundown, ladies and gentlemen. Brian Smith taking the win. Second, Sean Bear on the KTM. Third, Nicole Meese. Fourth is Jared Vandekoy keeping his rookie season going strong. Sammy Helbert takes fifth, and your final transfer is the number 49 of Chad Coase. Mick Kirkness, Jake Mattia, Colt Schmaltz, Shayna Texter are all done for the night. 11th through 13th is Duke Erickson. Stevie Bonzi had a tough break. Chaz Landers finishes in the 13th spot. So that was heat race number two. Up next will be our final heat race of the GNC1 class, and then we go into the GNC2 heat races, and we'll have two of those, and we'll take the top nine finishers to the main event. So give Brian Smith just a second to take off his showy helmet, and he'll talk to Danny Medine. Here we go. Let's go trackside with Danny, who's caught up to our heat race winner. Danny?
Nice. Oh, test. Make some noise for Brian Smith. Brian, every mile so far this season, you have been the king. You have been unstoppable. What is it about these mile tracks that works for you?
Calling me the king, man, that's pretty serious business there. I got my work cut out for me now, but man, I love these mile tracks. I've been racing Indy since I was on an 80cc motorcycle. I was about 9-10 years old, so I love this place. My team's based out of here, and I love Indianapolis.
What's it gonna take to win here tonight? Last year, you came up a little bit short.
Yeah, we had a couple problems last year, and Kenny beat us, but I think we got something for him this year and just got to get a good start and put our head down.
Keep your eyes on this guy. Scotty and Chris, back to you.
Thanks a lot. Up next, our final heat race in the GNC1 class, number two, Kenny Coolbeth Jr. from Center Hill, Florida. Number 10, Johnny Lewis on the Ducati from Ocala, Florida. Starting third, number 14, Briar Bauman, Salinas, California. 55, Jake Shoemaker, Glenmore, Pennsylvania on the Triumph. Doug Lawrence, Mississauga, Ontario, Canada on the 73. Cale Kochman on the 98 from Ventura, California. Row number two, 23Y, Ryan Foster. 23, Jeffrey Carver, Jr. 20T, Mikey LaBelle from Ontario. 66Y, Dominic Calendres on the Babe DeMay Yamaha. It's 94K, Jake Cunningham, Sherwood, Wisconsin. The 12 of Jay Maloney, Oakland, New Jersey. And rounding out your field on row number three, the 50P from Springfield, Illinois. That is Kurt Marmer. And that is our final heat race of the GNC1 class. Chris, are you ready for this one?
I am ready. It's interesting to watch the choice of Kenny Coolbeth. The previous two heat race pole sitters chose the outside. Coolbeth goes down the inside. We know that on a night like this, tracks or starts are much more important. We'll see if this one pays off going into turn one.
There's a Christmas tree with the red, two yellows, and a green, and we are off. Johnny Lewis kind of stumbles a little bit. Coolbeth grabs the hole shot from the inside, and he's got company on the outside. The 98 of Cale Kochman brings him around the outside, so it's Coolbeth on the Zanotti Harley to lead him off of turn number two. Here comes Doug Lawrence on the 73. Kawasaki making a bid for second place.
Yeah, Coolbeth checking out. You know, this looks a lot like what he did in the main event here a year ago. This guy loves this racetrack. Track starting to form a little bit of rubber going off into the corner, and this track gets a groove on it where he went immediately.
Ooh.
Oh,
Lawrence.
Ride'em Cowboy there hits a little rut on the outside edge of the groove. Holds on to it, though. And
holds on to second place also. Go ahead.
This track, Kenny Coolbeth loves it when it gets a little bit of rubber on it. He had disappeared here a year ago, and it could bring in some tire wear issues. These guys, a year ago, ran almost out of rubber. So new this year with the Dunlop-built tires, it's going to be a great test to see how well they perform.
Well, the one thing is there's two less semis and one last chance qualifier for the GNC2 class, so maybe not as much rubber will be on the racetrack. We'll see how tire wear is. We got a great battle back here. Doug Lawrence, Cale Kochman, and the 14 of Briar Bauman battling for second place. Briar squares off the corner. He comes off the bottom. He's going to try to bring him off at turn number four in the two spot.
And we got the 10 of Johnny Lewis on the Ducati. Multi-brands here going at it for top six here. Wow. Impressive.
Shoemaker's up there joining the hunt on the 55. He's also on a factory Triumph effort. So it's Coolbeth out front. Doug Lawrence was showed in second. Now Briar Bauman takes over second. Cale Kochman's putting the pressure on the 73 bike of Doug Lawrence. Now it looks like Johnny Lewis is battling back there with the 55 of Shoemaker.
Yeah, Shoemaker had a pretty good run going last week as he has a little shimmy down the back straightaway. These guys here, they're all in the final, but they're fighting for rows right now. A couple of them are fighting for the dash to try and get an extra point. The rest of them are going to be fighting for a position on the starting line, essentially.
So it's Coolbeth out front. Doug Lawrence now in second. Now he's back to the third. Now Lawrence goes back up the inside, takes over second. Bauman back to third. Johnny Lewis right there on the 10. 98, Kochman, 55 is Shoemaker. And here comes the 23, Jeffrey Carver Jr. He sees this battle going in front of him. Look at him go through one and two.
Three abreast coming off of turn two, darn near four.
Carver, while these guys mix it up, is starting to inch forward on him. So we're going to have six guys going for the five final transfer positions of the final. John, this is some great racing.
Johnny
right here.
Lewis burps the throttle going into turn number three, drops to the bottom of the racetrack on that Ducati. He applies the pressure and goes around Bauman. Now he's looking to go past the 73 of Doug Lawrence. Here they come off of four.
A great turn three and four for the 10 of Johnny Lewis on the Ducati. This is a great battle for essentially a spot in the dash in the front row, as we see a little bump forming it going into turn one, kind of upsetting the chassis a little bit. It's lower on the racetrack. Some guys can go around it. Some of them, you know, they're going right through it.
Is that the bump of where the cars were going across the racetrack to come into the pit area? Is that possibly what that is from?
Very possible. That seems to be in the area where it's developed. Sometimes it's before or after. We see a few holes here through the middle of the racetrack.
Doug
in
Lawrence.
Turns three and four as well. So those guys are going to got a tough track conditions here for
Doug
them to
Lawrence.
Navigate.
Doug Lawrence has his hands full on the 73 bikes, bouncing around a little bit. He's dropping back now. Here comes Carver. Carver comes on by one rider. He's looking for some more. Coolbet has checked out of this one. Second through seventh is right there in front of you. Now they're in turns one and two.
Breyer Bauman with a bold move around the outside of the 10 of Johnny Lewis. Looked like he didn't lift at all. Went up around that bump, held the throttle to the stop, and finds himself in second as the 10 appears to out-accelerate a little bit down the back straightaway.
Look at Shoemaker all the way up to the four spot. He was back quite a ways, and he's tracked these guys down, started making some passes. That puts Cale Kolkman, the odd man, out right now as Carver's put himself into the sixth spot.
Yeah, we see these guys kind of starting to drop down to the bottom here. As Kenny Coolbeth has checked out into the distance, I would imagine he's running around the bottom of the racetrack too. That's only going to add a little bit more rubber to the racetrack a little bit sooner.
Bauman goes back to the high side, turns one and two, trying to go around the outside of Lewis, and does in the middle of the corner. Grabs a handful, old school flat track, and up in the deep stuff. Bauman takes over second once again. Johnny Lewis in third, Shoemaker fourth, Doug Lawrence, Jeffrey Carver. That's our top six right now. The odd rider out looking for a way in is the 98 of Kolkman, as now Lawrence is back there in the sixth spot.
What a great battle. I mean, all this in a heat race, I'm really looking forward to the main event.
Absolutely.
This is fantastic.
We had 13 riders start this one. Seven riders battling right here for second. The white flag comes out for your leader, Coolbet. Here's second, Lewis. We got one rider off the pace in turn number three. No harm, no foul. We'll race until we see red or checkered. Battle for second. Bauman goes back to the high side. Johnny Lewis on the inside. Bauman's up against the air fence, throwing the roost.
Whoa,
look at him.
Lewis just about clips the rear wheel of the 14 of Breyer Bauman coming off of turn two. That was a close one, folks.
White flags out. Leader's already in three and four. Here comes your leader off of turn number four right now. Let's go back out to the leader off of four. Here he comes. It's Coolbeth on the two bike running the very bottom of the racetrack. Here he's going to bring him off of four and take the heat race win. Coolbeth, your winner. Let's go back to the battle for second, third, and fourth. Here they come all the way back to sixth.
Yeah, great race. They kind of fanned out on that last lap, the last few laps. But Kenny Coolbeth, another convincing victory here over Breyer Bauman.
So Breyer Bauman takes second. Third is Johnny Lewis on the number 10. 55 is Shoemaker all the way up to fourth. Jeffrey Carver came from deep in the field to fifth. And Doug Lawrence will take our final transfer spot from Mississauga, Ontario, Canada. So a tough break for Cale Kolkman, Ryan Foster, Jake Cunningham, Mikey LaBelle, Jay Maloney, Kurt Marmer, and they said Dominic Calendras ended up one lap short as the Yamaha did not finish the race there. Dominic Calendras comes up just a little bit short. How about that dominating performance from Coolbeth?
Really no surprise. Kenny Coolbeth likes this racetrack. He likes it when it starts to take a little bit of rubber. We're seeing a bit of a free-for-all through turns one and two, but we're starting to see the groove, albeit not very wide, develop down on the bottoms of turns three and four. We see some rough conditions through the middle. It can be interesting to see if Brad Baker can continue to ride this racetrack the way he's been riding it. We saw him doing a good job of squaring it up. Coolbeth running it around the bottom, kind of building his racetrack. So when the main event comes around, going to be very, very interesting to see which plan plays out the best.
Kenny Coolbeth, who won here last year, looking to go back-to-back here at the Indy Mile. Let's go trackside with Danny Medine and our heat race winner.
All right, thanks you guys. This track suits your style. You like it smooth, you like it fast. You won here last year. What's it gonna take to do it again this year?
By the looks of it, we gotta keep that Brad Baker behind us. He's just amazing on these loose tracks. It's getting pretty hard right now, so it's more suiting my style. So hopefully we can give him a run for his money. He's pretty fast right now. But Zanotti Harley-Davidson, Harley-Davidson Motor Company, Gator Harley-Davidson Monster effort, it's just great, you know. So I'm looking forward to the 25-lap main event.
Well, you're going on, so good luck to you. Scotty and Chris, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Danny. Up next, GNC2 heat race action. This will have six laps, and we will take the top nine finishers. So number 67M is our points leader, Davis Fisher. 44E, Nick Armstrong. 68A, Ryan Varnes. 23F, Jeffrey Lowry. 30Z, that is Bronson Bauman. 58A is Roy Miller. That is your front row. Row number two, 14A, Dalton Gauthier. 11Z, Andrew Luker. 24J, Brandon Wilhelm. 36B, that's Colby Carlisle. 89C, Chris Boone. And the 11G, that's Gary Ketchum. And road number three, we got the 43C of Lloyd Widener and the 55L of Cole King. Again, we'll take the top nine finishers directly to the main event, as we will not have last chance qualifier for this class and no semifinals for the GNC1. We do know Mother Nature is a factor here today. We're trying to get all the races in that we can. So that's what the plan is today.
Yeah, these guys want to get off to a good start. Davis Fisher wanting to build on his point lead, 18 points at the moment in the GNC2 class. We've got a heck of a battle for second, as six riders are divided by 8 points. Green light goes.
From the inside, Roy Miller snags the hole shot. He's going to take Bronson Bauman with him, but from the outside, Davis Fisher on the 67M. He says, not so fast. The new rider goes in the middle of the pack.
Yeah, Roy Miller, good start off into turn one. Davis Fisher around the outside as it goes 2-3 wide off of turn two. The kid wants to streak away out front.
Nick Armstrong in the two spot. Suzuki ran very strong at the Springfield Mile. He had trouble getting off the line on that 20. He's never rode it before there at Springfield, so now he's got some seat time, and he's getting off the line a little bit stronger. He drops to the bottom of the racetrack. We got a dogfight for the lead.
Yeah, he got a good drive coming off of turn two, kind of squared up out of three, brought the thing back down to the bottom. Momentum, gets a good drive and picks up the draft and runs it up the inside. Woo! As they come close together into turn one.
I thought he was going to run right into Davis and go down.
Yeah, that was a close one. Davis holds on, gets a good drive. Let's see if we can do a little back and forth action with the draft here.
Down the back straightaway, it's Fisher, Nick Armstrong in second. We got Foster up there in the third spot, that's Jeffrey Lowry up to the third spot. He's got a bunch of company behind him. Now Ryder goes up the inside, takes over that third position. Good two-rider battle for the lead, and it's everybody else from there on back. I'm glad I'm not a scorekeeper.
Yeah, no kidding. As we saw Fisher out front there, just kind of teetered right on the edge of the groove, kept the wheels in line. Ran the thing around on the bottom. I think he's chosen where he wants to ride, at least in turns three and four, as he opens up about a 3 or 4 bike gap.
Bronson Bauman takes over the third spot. Jeffrey Lowry in fourth. Andrew Luker, the Daytona short track winner, moves up to the fifth spot on the Kennedy Racing Harley. Behind him is Varnes on the 68. Dalton Gauthier is there. Colby Carlisle across the line was in the ninth and final transfer spot. He's on a borrowed Suzuki this week.
Yeah, good run for Colby as we go two wide off into turn three. Luker gets kind of hung out up against the air fence, finding it hard to get back down to the bottom. The battle now for second heating up as Bauman inches forward on Nick Armstrong for second.
Fisher starting to pull away the 67M. Nick Armstrong looks like he might have settled into the two spot. Bronson Bauman's applying the pressure to the 30Z on the Lombardi's Harley-Davidson entry. Now goes to work on Armstrong for second.
Yeah, good drive off the corner for Bauman. Slots in behind Armstrong, hoping to get a draft. We've seen the strength of the Kawasaki's in GNC1. We're seeing that in GNC2 as Nick Armstrong hits a nice big hole there going off into turn three. Brings his rear end up out of the saddle, goes ride him cowboy off into the middle of three and four.
But he's hanging on to that spot right there in second. He's got Bronson Bauman there and Jeffrey Lowry right there on the 23F. Lowry looks at the inside.
Well, Lowry, an Ohio kid, likes these loose racetracks. He likes having that thing stepped out. He finds himself fighting for position here to top three. Man, in this class will go to the front row, and I think that'll be an important place for these guys to start. So
everywhere we're looking, there's good racing on the racetrack. Top nine finishers to the main event right now. The ninth spot is the 56A of Roy Miller's Colt.
Big
Lowry,
cowboy
Lowry
moment.
Saves it somehow. The 23F was all over the motorcycle. He's trying for the save of the year.
I'd say he's a shoe-in for it right now with one lap to go as these guys battle for position. But that was a that was a heck of a save. We're starting to see a hole develop right off the edge of the groove going off into turn three, and it's not getting any smaller. It's only getting deeper.
As a GNC1 rider right now, are you trying to watch the racetrack? Because your main event's going to be coming up soon.
Well, if they're not watching on Fans Choice TV, they should be down there on their mini bike in the corner checking it out, because that was that's a big hole that these guys are finding their way into. Is Davis Fisher creeps it up off the edge of the groove, trying the outer line, trying a little bit of the cushion, gets it turned. Heads for home, another checker flag, another heat race win for Davis Fisher.
A little bit of head shake coming to the finish line. Davis Fisher taking a win in a commanding fashion. Here's the battle for everybody else, second through the rest of them, coming across the start finish line. Fisher taking the win for sure. We know that, as that has already gone across the scoreboard, and the rest of the time's coming across just as soon as we can. The rest of the riders taking the finish right there. Nick Armstrong will take second on the 44E. Third spot, Bronson Bauman. Jeffrey Lowry, with that great save a lap or two ago, comes home fourth. Andrew Luker will take fifth. Third-generation racer, that's Kevin Barnes' son, Ryan Barnes, will take the sixth spot. Dalton Gauthier, seventh. Colby Carlisle, eighth. And your final transfer is the 56A, Roy Miller. Actually had the hole shot there for a little while. Went backwards just a little bit, so Roy Miller's your last transfer. Chris Boone, Cole King, Gary Ketchum, Brandon Wilhelm, and Lloyd Widener all are done for the evening. So that was it for GNC2. Heat race number one. We have one more qualifying heat race. There's a very happy Davis Fisher, who's trying to stretch out his points lead. The heat races don't pay any points, Chris, but it definitely looks and shows how fast he is here tonight.
Yeah, this kid's been solid. You know, he was really strong last year, got kind of a late start to the year. Now he's up on a GNC1 level bike. Getting some good solid experience here at some of the mile races. This kid has a very bright future, and he's getting better every time he hits the racetrack. So congratulations to him, and this is a star of the future right here. Down to Danny.
Noise, test, test. Make some noise for our current GNC2 points leader and Heat 1 GNC2 heat winner. That's a mouthful. You were on fire out there, dominating in those last couple laps. Take us through that race.
Well, I got off to a decent start and had a guy up the inside, and I just rolled around the outside and just kind of put my head down and tried to click off some fast laps.
You have a great team behind you. Who would you like to thank?
Oh, yeah, I'd like to thank Parkson Brothers Racing, Ball Bland Fierce, Beaverton Honda, Dan Wall Racing, Allied Motors, my Uncle Ryan, Arai Helmets, Saddleman Seats, Nemo Plates, Victory Circle Graphics, Fly Racing, and all the fans for coming out.
Good luck in the main event. Scotty and Chris, back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Danny. That was our first GNC2 heat race winner, Davis Fisher. Up next, GNC2 heat race number two. Number 54A, Dan Bromley. 24F, J.R. Addison. 16M, Austin Elmoles. 47F, Austin Connett. 94B, Flying Ryan Wells. 72F, Tyler Butts. That is your front row. Last week's winner will be the first pick on the second row. This is 16S, Tristan Avery. 27U, Jamison Miner. 23Z, James Monaco. 10L, Mac McGrew. 17A, Jordan Harris, and the 17C, Sean McNary. Row number three, the 32C, Brian McRoberts, and the 74F, Barry Binkert Jr. Last qualifying heat race of the day. After this one, we're going to take a short break so they can do some track maintenance before we come back with our 25-lap Grand National main event. The teams can go back and get ready. So this is our last qualifying race of the afternoon. We'll have our first scheduled intermission right after this race, ladies and gentlemen. So be ready to head down there and pick up your souvenir t-shirt. It's got Kenny Coolbeth on it. If you're the first 500 people, you get a towel right here. These things are really cool, the rally towels. First 500 people to get there and spend $25, get one. Here we go, heat race number two, GNC2 class.
Had a good qualifying run by the 54A on the Bill Werner Kawasaki. Certainly has a lot of experience in his pit area. Not the greatest of starts, but the 94B of Ryan Wells out front. Bromley up at the inside, immediately wanted to take his position at the front.
Dan Bromley on the Warner, Kawasaki up the inside, Ryan Wells on the outside, the 94B. Here comes Tyler Butts up the inside, and Tristan Avery from row number two up to the four spot. He's bringing Helmholtz with him.
You know, we saw a little bit of this from Avery last week. You know, he wasn't the strongest in practice. He's all the way up into the third position as he navigate the bumps into turn three. This kid has been on a tear of late. Full of confidence. He hasn't qualified well, but he's certainly been racing well.
So this is our last qualifying race of this afternoon. We will have our Dash for Cash after the two main events. So the next race we will see will be GNC1 main event. We will take a break after this to put some moisture down. It's Ryan Wells out front. Dan Bromley in second. Tyler Butts shown in the third spot. Tristan Avery now back up there into the third.
Oh! We have a rider bounce off the concrete wall coming off.
That was Max McGrew, and he looked like he was wide open and slid off the groove, and what a save.
Wow, I don't know what happened there. It looked like the cushion just kind of – sometimes you get up in that deep stuff and you can't get out of it, but he kept it on the gas all the way until contact with the wall. Great save by Max McGrew, but I have a feeling he's going to feel that tomorrow.
Yeah, his right foot definitely going to be feeling it as Manny got into that backstraight wall. Mac McGrew got in there deep and got off the groove back there in turn number two.
But out front, the 94B of Ryan Wells in control. 54A of Dan Bromley in second. 16S, 16-year-old Tristan Avery running third. Tyler Butts on the 72 on the Harley in fourth. These riders starting to running all over, starting to find that the bottom part of the racetrack is the place to be. The 24 F of J.R. Addison moves up a position.
Remember, nine riders go into the main event. Everybody else is done, so it's Wells out front, Dan Bromley in second. As they go across the start-finish line, things are going to change. Tristan Avery still in the third spot, last week's winner. Tyler Butts in fourth. Austin Helmholtz now is slipping back to the sixth spot as J.R. Addison's moved up to the fourth spot on the 24F. James Monaco's now in the seventh spot. Jamison Minor eighth. And Mac McGrew, who had that save, is still in the ninth spot, Chris.
Yeah, it's great to see him out there running around. He's holding on to a transfer position to the final. But that's going to hurt tomorrow, I think.
Oh, yeah. Man, he got in there hard. And that concrete wall had no protection right there. Here comes down the front straightaway. It's your leader, Wells. He's starting to get some company. Bromley can see him. So can Tristan Avery. Good battle back in the field just a little bit further.
Yeah, we see the 23Z of James Monaco on the Engelhart Racing Technologies Honda 1000 having one of his better finishes here or better performances so far this year in a well into transfer spot, sitting in eighth currently.
We got a battle for the lead heating up. They'll be coming to the white flag this time by off of turn number four. It is Wells, but he has company. Dan Bromley is there, and so is Tristan Avery. Here comes your leaders off of turn number four, back at the front straightaway. White flag's going to be coming out. It's Wells. Here comes Bromley.
Bromley getting a good draft up the front straightaway. Tries to make a move up the inside, goes below the bumps, kind of skids it up a little bit above Wells in the middle of the corner, but then they drop back down to the bottom as the rubber starts to lay in at the extreme exit of turn two. That could change things a little bit here as the evening wears on.
Down the back straightaway, it's Wells. Here comes Bromley looking, sneaking a peek up the inside. Bromley tries the low line to take the lead. Wells puffing, looked like a puff of smoke maybe possibly came out when he let off the throttle going in. Bromley's going to lead him off of four. Wells ducks back in line, shaking his head. He knows he made the mistake and left the door open. They'll drag race to the finish line. It's Bromley. Here comes Wells. Wells swings out. He pulled out too soon, I think. It's going to be Bromley and Wells across the finish line. Avery right there in the third spot. J.R. Addison fourth, and everybody else comes across the finish line. We'll give you the top nine finishers in just a second. Here comes Sean McNary. Might have snuck in there at the last second on the 17C. So that is going to be it for our final heat race of the afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, or evening time. Your winner, the 54A Dan Bromley, 94B Ryan Wells takes second. Tristan Avery comes home third. J.R. Addison fourth. Tyler Butts fifth. Jamison Miner's been having a good season sixth. James Monaco on that Honda. And we know that's a 1,000 Hawk engine, I believe is what we're hearing. Austin Helmholtz will get the 8th spot, and Sean McNary takes the final transfer, number 17C. Tough break for Mac McGrew, man. What a ride. He went into that back straightaway wall at full speed and bounced off of it. Good thing nobody got into him. 11th will be Jordan Harris. 12th is Brian McRoberts. 20C of Michael Dillon. 14th, Barry Binkert. And Austin Connett will take that 15th and final transfer spot. Again, we are going to have a short break after this winning interview, and we'll come back. The next race on the track is our 25-lap Grand National main event. Man.
Wow.
This racing is awesome.
Great show so far. It was nice to see a race go down to the line.
Wells' bike is smoking as he's pushing it back there or coasting it back there into the pit area. We'll have to keep our eyes on that one and see if he can. Yeah, I know he has a backup bike, but we'll see if he'll switch that backup and take a risk of running that bike right there. So Dan Bromley will take his motorcycle superstore helmet off. He's already had it undone. He knew where he was going. Let's go to the victory podium and Danny.
Make some noise for Dan Bromley. taken the win in GNC2. You had a great running qualifying. I was kind of hoping you would get up here. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm feeling pretty good. Anytime I can ride one of Bill's bikes, I'm happy. We went out there first practice, fast qualified on this bike, hopped on the backup bike, see what it did, ended up second, came back on this bike, and I ended up winning.
So you're going on to the main event. What are your expectations?
My expectations are to do what I did right now, try and get a good start and run up front, and then near the end of the race, make some smart decisions and be up front.
You got a couple sponsors you would like to thank?
Oh, yeah, I can't thank Bill Warner enough and Johnny for coming out and doing all the work. DC Racing, Supertrap, Pilot Leathers, Motion Pro, Saddleman, Redline Oil, NJK. DC, helping out, buying some t-shirts, repping me. I can't thank him enough, and all the fans at MA Pro for putting this race on.
Well, congratulations and good luck in the main. You guys, the best racing is still to come, so don't.